This is Jack Conwell, known as the Unknown Pilot RC. I'm going to talk about installing a Gull Wing Bone in a top model RC. My Corsair was one of the first groups sent out and had a reported problem of the mid-wing section breaking. This video will show you how I reinforced the mid-wing section back in January of 2021 and flew that summer. I was waiting to see if the company was going to replace the midsection, but that did not happen. And I know some of you are worried about flying yours. This is how I did mine. I call it a fix and not a patch, so let me know what you think. The video shows a series of pictures I took during the rebuilding, and I will talk about additional changes that you may want to make. Toward the end of the video, I will show the wing joining, the hydraulic gear, and the hydraulic brakes. Subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. I hope this will give you some inspiration.
Yeah.
Is that any better?
Now we're going to start out with the hardest thing first, and that's removing the two inner gear doors, which you have to be able to save those hinges. So we're going to grind just a little bit out so we can extract those pins. You're going to grind a little slot in the shell of the main section to try to get those pins out of there. And here you can see the 3/4 tape. I ran from one side to the other. We're going to be cutting this thing out, and that's how we, gives us a nice guide to go by. And you'll see the Dremel wheel, just a diamond wheel, and it'll slide down through there and it'll cut that out in the heartbeat. If you get a little bit too deep, that's all right. It doesn't hurt. Our epoxy's gonna make up for everything. And just another view of it. You're gonna be surprised when we open this up how easy this is gonna be. It's like, wow. It's gonna be a piece of cake, so. Coming up here, just use a vacuum sweeper. I've already got it cut out. We're going to wiggle it back and forth, and you'll see that lightweight epoxy they used kind of fatigues out pretty quick. So we need to pop this off all in one strip, so just be patient and just wiggle. And it will come out, and you can see it right there. So if that wing starts moving any at all, that epoxy's going to start letting loose, so. Here's the tool I made. I just extended the blade on out, just silicone brazed it. So use the vibrating saw, it'll go in there and zip that stuff right out without breaking it. And you can see if we're just a little bit off, that's all right too. Our epoxy's gonna make up for it, and the pieces we put in will make up for it later. We're bending the rod, and it's aluminum, 1/8-inch aluminum rod to fit the bottom, which in this case is the top part of the wing, but we're gonna bend the bottom one first, and then we're gonna move up and we're gonna do the top one also. You can see the top one here, kind of bending it in place, getting it pretty close where we want it. We only have to worry about getting close. And you can see the rods are laying in there again. And I use what I call baseline to measure off of to get the distance of the two rods when we get ready to do the layout. This is just your scrap balsa, just zapped together to give you a bigger piece. Do your layouts. If it takes you one or two of these to get everything just right, well, it took me two, so. You just want to kind of get your pattern down and make sure everything fits and just do the best you can and it'll be good. Just come back and remark it to get everything to fit and resand it. Mine's 31 inches long, which almost goes from one side to the other, but we have to wiggle to get it in. And so there's the pattern in place. And you'll see the box is cut out. It has to straddle the box. And do not cut those pieces I cut out right there. You're seeing through those lines. You need to have a hole there to give it better support for your hydraulic line or your air line. There's just gonna be one of them going through there. The other one's gonna come back through a different route. instead of running both of them through the same hole. There's not really any need. That joining spar needs to be quite a bit longer, and it needs to be cut out to straddle that box just enough to go in there. You can see I use bolts out here. They have to be high and low, blind nuts behind them, because your joining wing spar slides in and out of there. It doesn't get glued in. So we're going to make that super strong, and we're going to extend that joining section on out farther. And every place we can, we're going to go in and glass and epoxy that section to the any wood to the shell. This is just a layout piece here. You're going to see how it goes in later. Just making sure everything's going to fit before we glue this main wing bone in. And it goes almost all the way out to the end. Gives us a lot of support. And the doubler can go all the way out to right up in here. It would be just fine. So we've got everything fitted, ready to smooth, and we can go through these holes and glass that in also when we get it in place. Those extra holes is for airlines and control lines that goes from the front of the wing to the other side of the main spar. And anything to get it in place, these are just window shims. Blocking that up, the more clamps, the merrier. And it's really going to add a lot of support to this plane right quick. I mean, it happens pretty quick. Because you open it up and you can see all the flaws that can happen inside here. I cut these out on the table saw and then cut them in length to join the wing webs back to the main spar. They get filled up with epoxy and put back in place. You can see it right here. Just make sure they're not high. Make sure your little strip fits in there really good. If they're a little bit low, that's all right. The epoxy's going to make up for it. Just another view here to look at. You can see everything's joined. Now we're getting ready to put the spray on this glass cloth, because it has to be tacked in place, because it's going to hold the epoxy in place. The sucker sticks are the finding the flat spots that's going to hold that strip in place exactly where we want it. But there's going to be tape underneath of it. So now we're going to load this up with like 30-minute epoxy. Going to put quite a bit in there. And then we're going to put the tape on it. And flip this thing upside down. So coming up here, you're going to see the tape with the sticks on it. You can go through the holes and run your epoxy any place you can with your brush. You can see the tape on it here. There's a full taped. You can see the sucker sticks on there. It's going to hold it flat in place. And we're going to turn this upside down and let the epoxy run back against that strip that we just put in. And it's going to do a good job. This is when it's done. You're going to see we have a gap through there still after we pulled the tape on, and that's all right. We're going to take a syringe, and we're going to use 5-minute or 30-minute, and we're going to wet our finger with a little bit of alcohol and rub it down, smooth everything out, rough sand it just a little bit, and put a little gray primer on it. And when it's all said and done, it's pretty good. And we're going to see additional spots where I would recommend that we go in and, or you go in and glass it. This one, we kind of get it finished up here. I would put extra glass and cloth right up in here. I mean, you just as well while you're there, so. That part is pretty well on the downhill slide. Now the gear door mechanism, I hinged it in the back. It's just 1/8-inch steel welding rod again. And you can see where the tire goes up and pushes against it. The springs are to keep the doors open while you're flying. You can see a little stop block. The linkage is made out of helicopter parts, of course. You can see the 150 gears with the gear doors mounted right on it for the gear itself. It does leave a little gap between there, but you know, I made this to fly. So when the gear's down, you don't notice that anyway. These are 150 gears, again, highly modified. They have full-size tires on them. This is the hydraulic system poked down in there. We do have a video on it, which will be coming up one of these days. I do have a video that tells you how to modify the 150 gears. This is a hydraulic brake system, which works really good. It'll put out 250 pounds. We only need about 80 pounds again, is all we need. It works really good. It's separate from the hydraulic gear system, by the way. We're just checking everything out, make sure it works. Everything is totally adjustable, so we can take that little gap out of them doors even. Get it looking a little better. Another view of the hydraulic system, which only weighs like 12 ounces. This is the wing joining spars, which this is the part that gets epoxy into the wing. And so I put lightning holes in it. And coming up here, you have to change the angle of the aluminum wing tubes. Just a Phillips screwdriver and start pecking them down. And they will move. And this is the mounting screw that holds the wing on, just a quarter inch plastic bolt. And it actually screws down into the joining spar itself. You can see how it slides in and out. Works really good. So this is an overall view of the wings working. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope this kind of helps you out a little bit along the way, but this is how I did mine, and it may not be the answer for you, but in my case, everything works just fine. The plane works good, so have a good day. Bye.